We will talk about the checks and testing of various components of an ILR or DF in this video. Let's begin by testing an overload protector. There are two types of protectors, namely internal and external. This is an external protector. A protector can be tested by a multimeter as well as a power test lamp. Let's first test this protector using a multimeter. The range on continuity is to be selected. The continuity on the protector should be checked. The sound of a buzzer confirms continuity in the protector. Let's now test the protector with a power test lamp. The glowing of the test lamp confirms continuity in the protector. This is a relay or a starting device. A starting relay permits the flow of electricity to the start winding during startup. Starting relays are usually of two types: LMS relay or electronic relay. Let's check the relay with a multimeter. The coil shows continuity since the buzzing sound can be heard. This is normally open contacts relay. It should not show any continuity when the relay is in upward position. Now let us check the normally open contacts when the relay is upside down. In this position, it should show the continuity, which confirms that the relay is in order. Similarly, the relay can be checked with a series powered test lamp. The bulb glows and continuity is confirmed. The relay needs to be replaced if the coils are burnt. We will now test a PTC relay. PTC relay also can be checked by a multimeter as well as a power test lamp. Always shake it by hand before checking the relay. An internal rattle noise can be heard. To check it by a multimeter, select the appropriate range on the multimeter. Perform the resistance measurement test. To measure the resistance between the terminals meant for main winding and start winding. Now let's test the heating effect of the PTC material using a series test lamp. Put in the probes in the M and S terminals. The lamp glows for a while and later on it automatically turns off. This shows that the resistance of PTC material has increased. This is a capacitor used for motor or compressor starting purpose. Defective or weak capacitor can cause starting problems. To check the start capacitor, we require a clamp meter or a multimeter, test lamp, or rated mains voltage. Let's test the capacitor using clamp meter. Select the appropriate range. The reading shows that the capacitor is getting charged. Now, when we reverse the probes, it seems to be getting discharged. This shows that the capacitor is functioning properly. Let's now use a power test lamp. Plug the power test lamp to the power supply. Put the probes of the power test lamp on the capacitor's connections. The lamp glows. This proves that the capacitor is in working condition. Let's test the capacitor by applying rated mains voltage to it for a few seconds and then short-circuiting the leads. If spark appears, the capacitor is in order. We will now test a thermostat. Thermostat is an essential controlling component of a refrigeration system. There are mainly two types of thermostats: mechanical thermostat and solid state or electronic control thermostat. This is a mechanical thermostat. It is the most commonly used thermostat in the refrigeration system. It is equipped with a vapor pressure sensing bulb. It uses volatile liquid within the sensing bulb. Vapor pressure affects the diaphragm and a capillary tube is used that connects controls to bulbs. It has moving parts of contacts. This is an electronic thermostat. It has no moving parts, unlike the mechanical thermostat. It uses a thermistor as a sensing device, and its resistance varies with the temperature. Generally, it is used to accurately measure temperature extremes. Let's test the mechanical thermostat. For its testing, we require a powered test lamp and crushed ice in a bowl. As we check, continuity in this thermostat contacts is present as the bulb glows. We will now check cutoff operation of thermostat by inserting its sensing element into the crushed ice. When the set point temperature is attained, the bulb stops glowing. This shows that the thermostat is in working order. Let's test an electronic thermostat. The test setup is same as the mechanical thermostat. The bulb is used as the load for the component. A glowing bulb depicts a normal closed condition for the contacts. We will now put the sensor in crushed ice. The controller is set to cut the temperature at 4 degrees. The bulb turns off, showing that the contacts are now open and the load is disconnected from the controller. Let's now check the restart operation. After the set differential temperature, the bulb will glow again. This proves that the thermostat is working fine. If the lamp glows continuously, then it means thermostat is not working properly and temperature of equipment will fluctuate. Now let's talk about a compressor. In ice-lined refrigerator and deep freezer, commonly used compressors are of reciprocating type and hermetically sealed. This is a reciprocating type and hermetically sealed compressor. Compressor generally fails due to improper voltage supply, moisture in the system, high operating temperature, blocked condenser, faulty electrical components, and largely due to poor maintenance. Let us perform electrical checks for the compressor. We will now perform the ground test for the compressor and check the compressor for grounding, if any. Multimeter is the most commonly used instrument for such kind of testing. Keep the selector switch of multimeter at appropriate position. Check the compressor body for solid grounding or earth connection. Check the winding terminals for the grounding, if any. Multimeter reading shows no continuity between winding terminal and compressor body. It means there is no compressor grounding.